This viscous liquid is sandwiched between flexible electrodes. When it is tapped, an electric pulse is generated. This phenomenon has long been a feature of solid piezoelectric materials. However, NIMS succeeded in developing a liquid-type piezoelectric material for the first time in the world. They're called liquid electric materials, and they're expected to open new horizons for batteryless sensors powered by external forces, including heartbeats and touch. An electret is a material that can retain an electrical charge on its surface. Thus, vibration or deformation of the material generates an electrical current. They're used in many everyday items, microphones for example. This is an electret. It converts vibrations in the air into electrical signals. You can find them in many things, but they're all solids. If electret materials can be created with liquid-like deformability, we can make many novel products, says Dr. Takashi Nakanishi. An expert in molecular design, he has invented a special technique for converting molecular solids into liquids. For example, fullerene powder doesn't liquefy until it reaches temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Celsius. However, in 2006, he caused it to liquefy at room temperature and stunned the world. To convert a molecular solid into a liquid, he attached branched side chains to the molecular surface. Fullerene is a molecule made up of carbon atoms in this configuration. These molecules form a solid because they are closely packed together. We attached branched hydrocarbon side chains to the surface, like this. The spherical cores are loosely packed within the surrounding chains, causing them to become amorphous, namely, a liquid. With this technique, Dr. Nakanishi has converted various solid molecules into liquids, including fluorophores and dyes. This time, he succeeded in developing a liquid that can retain an electrical charge. Let's observe how it's made. First, a solid core molecule is dissolved in this solvent. This yellow solution contains the molecules for the side chains that will attach to the core molecule. They are mixed to form the target compound. Then, the solution containing the final compound is extracted through column chromatography. Finally, the solvent is evaporated, leaving the liquid compound behind. The next step is to charge this liquid compound with some electricity, making it an electret material. It is then sandwiched between two soft electrodes. Here is the final soft device capable of generating electricity. Let's watch how it works with this circuit tester. When the device is tapped, electricity is generated. Our technique gives liquid materials a new function that was previously only possible with solid devices. We'd like to hear from users of other solid devices that could have novel applications if they were flexible. In response to their specific ideas, we're ready to propose recipes for various liquids composed of favorable molecules. We'd be glad to make their ideas a reality with our molecular design. Now we can convert highly functional solid materials into liquids. NIMS widens the applications of materials with newly developed technologies.